Hi guys, Mal here from fishingtownsville.net. In this short video, I'm going to show you how to locate the Cocoa Creek boat ramp. Firstly, head south out of Townsville along the Bruce Highway for approximately 25 kilometres. Then make a left turn onto Cape Cleveland Road towards the Ames facility. Cape Cleveland Road is a sealed road and is in good condition. It does become cut off during periods of heavy rain and flooding, and care should be taken during twilight hours as kangaroos are common. Follow this road for approximately 12 kilometres. You will cross a small creek, and about 100 metres past this is a left turn onto a gravel road to Cocoa. The track to Cocoa Creek is rough and heavily corrugated in places. While a two-wheel drive car can navigate the track with care, a four-wheel drive is definitely recommended. The condition of the track varies greatly. It is graded usually once a year, but wet season rains and heavy use degrade the track quickly. The track is only about 6 kilometres long, but will take about 20 minutes to drive. All up, allow about 45 minutes from Townsville. There is no real ramp at Cocoa, just a section of mud bank that is suitable for launching a small to medium sized boat. The ease of launching and retrieving here is directly related to the height of the tide. Some gravel has been placed by the locals to provide a little traction, but this is still a risky launch site. Four-wheel drive is required and extreme care should be taken. Small boats and good four-wheel drives can get in and out with 1 metre of tide, but I would recommend a minimum of 1.5 metres. Even 2 metres of tide will make life a lot easier. On 3 metres of tide, it's even possible to put slightly larger boats in. As this is not an official ramp and no maintenance is provided by the council, conditions vary greatly. Over the years, the bank has changed considerably and different launch sites have been selected. There is plenty of parking spaces available at the top of the bank, and camping is also common. There is no security or facilities at this ramp. It is common for cars to be broken into, and I would not recommend launching and leaving a car overnight. During the day, especially on the weekend, this spot is popular enough to keep cars safe. There are usually a couple of people fishing off the bank most days. Care should be taken when coming past these rocks, as the road narrows and it's difficult to see oncoming traffic. The remainder of the track is wide enough for two vehicles to be able to pass easily. The access point on Cocoa Creek is only 5 minutes run from the mouth. While the ocean can be accessed on 1 metre or better, the channel mouth through the flats is very long, narrow, and follows an unusual path. The water at low tide is usually dirty and you cannot see the path of the deeper water. Extreme care should be taken. It is a good idea to mark the channel with a GPS during the high tide. From the mouth of Cocoa, Crocodile Creek is only 5 minutes run away, and Cape Cleveland and the weed beds can be easily accessed with good protection from southeast winds. Cocoa Creek runs a reasonable distance upstream, but it narrows quickly and sections become shallow. Thank you. There are two small creek crossings to navigate on the Cocoa Creek Road, both of which only really contain water during the wet season, but care does need to be taken as they have steep entry and exit points and do become washed out from the heavy rains.
Thank you.
Hopefully you found this video useful. For more tips and information on fishing Townsville and the surrounding area, please like us on Facebook at facebook.com/fishingtownsville. Follow our Twitter feed at twitter.com/fishtownsville and subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/fishingtownsville. Our main website, which is full of great information and fishing reports, can be found at www.fishingtownsville.net. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you on the water soon.